Hello guys! In today's episode, we are gonna speak about how building up an online presence is gonna be absolutely beneficial for every business, even if your business doesn't deliver anything which is primary online and digital and it's something more physical, especially if you wanna take your business to the next level.
So let's imagine this situation. Saturday evening, yeah? You call your friends and you say, hey, let's go for a dinner tonight, no? And okay, yes, let's go for dinner.
Yeah.
And then one guy says, okay, I fancy, I don't know, a Chinese restaurant, Japanese restaurant, I don't know, some restaurant, no?
Some restaurant.
What do you do in that moment? Because you don't have a listing of restaurants in your head, right? But what's the first thing that you do? You go on the phone and you search Japanese or Chinese restaurants in
X, whatever you are.
Whatever you are, no? In London, in New York, in Miami, whatever you are. So, you go on the phone. That's one case, that's one situation. For example, you need a physio. And you go online and search for a physio. So even these businesses are physical businesses. They don't sell anything online. They don't need to. They are not Uber Eats or Deliveroo or whatever, or the physio is not selling you something online. But these businesses reach people, get people through the online...
The online world, definitely.
Exactly,
definitely.
The online world, the online platform. So what I think is that this online world can give a lot of benefits to online businesses, but to physical businesses. Even if you don't sell online, you can get the most from this online world.
Well, absolutely. I mean, as you said right now, as soon as we have like a kind of question, whatever it is, if we want to buy online or if we want to choose, if we want to know what's the best place to go to eat for holiday, on holidays, or to have, yes, a physiotherapy session, a massage session, the first thing that we do to check who's available, if we don't know, is to go online.
Go online. Even to get the how-to. You get something broken at home and you think, oh, let me find how to do this on YouTube. And there is a business creating content for you to know how to do something, no?
So everything nowadays basically happens online. All the researches, all the asking questions and finding answers to our questions happen online. So it doesn't matter the nature of the business that you have, the nature of the business that you run, the level of the business that you have or that you run. Building up an online presence is something that is gonna take you there where you're working so hard to go. What do you think?
So I think that's absolutely right. And I think there is one important exercise that we all need to do when we start either our business or when we want to take another to take the business to another level or to improve a part of the business or to get your physical business into this online world, no? Whatever the goal is, I think there is something that we all need to do.
So yeah, of course you need to know exactly what you're selling and you need to understand, you need to get to know properly your audience.
Exactly.
You need to understand where your audience is looking primarily for information, where these people they have a problem and they are looking, they want to solve this problem with something and that's why they are buying. And if the solution to their problem is what you offer, where are they looking for the information to then find your product or service and decide to buy from you? This is something that, of course, you need to understand. And as we said before, most of the people right now, it doesn't matter who these people are, they look for information online. So why not opening your market, opening your visibility to something so huge like it's the online world? That's a huge step forward for every business. And if you get to know your audience deep inside, deep to their thoughts, deep in their mind, it's when you are gonna literally make your sales, make your revenue increase at a level that you may even not think at the moment, because it's incredible the results that you can have.
Yeah, and what we have seen, for example, in our sessions when we go to businesses and explain how to understand the audience, what we find is that people know, businesses know what the audience is. They know who more or less buy from there. Yeah, it's teenagers. No, I sell to business owners. I sell to business owners that are in this specific industry, or we sell to. Yeah, but do you really know them? We think that this type of exercise is very important to understand, as Stefano is saying, to understand deeply them. Not like, yeah, no, I know, I'm trying to sell to businesses. Yeah, but who? Who are they? Behind businesses, there are people. Who are those people? That's the...
Well, that's the key, and that's the most complicated thing as well, because as you said, most of the businesses, they know more or less who are they selling their product to. And this more or less is often not enough. You need to get to know people very deep. You need to understand what's, first of all, your audience's biggest problem. That's the thing. As said before, the main thing that make people buy, if you think about what you guys, why you guys make purchases, is because you have a problem to solve. Whatever the problem is, you need something because you need to achieve something, or you need to fix an issue. So if you understand what's the biggest problem and of your audience, and you give your audience the solution to this problem through your product or service, is already a huge step forward, and you're gonna have huge results, huge an extreme increasement of sales and revenues, and people that are gonna start loving even more your brand, your name, and your product or service.
Exactly.
But the most difficult part of this exercise that we do with our clients and with other businesses is to get to know the audience into a very, very deeper level, which is understanding what's behind these needs to solve this problem. Why do I decide to solve this specific problem right now instead of focusing on other problem that I may have? There is something behind this. And this something may be desires, maybe fears, maybe different kind of emotions that we need to understand, studying deeply our audience. Because if we understand it, it's when we are gonna speak to our audience into a much more intimate level, and it's when they are gonna feel much more comfortable in making afterwards the decision to buy from you.
So, in order to conclude the video, whatever the goal is very important to have a base, and that base is knowing exactly your audience, who your audience is. And if you want to be in this online world with your business, it's very important to understand who is going to potentially buy from you.
That's the key. That's one of the main keys, and that's something that is at the base of every successful marketing. Whatever is online or not online, that's what you need to do.
So we hope you liked this content today, and if you'd like to know something different, if you'd like to ask us something, let us know in the comments, and then don't forget to follow us. And we see each other in the next episode.
Have a good one.